Hello everyone and welcome to this video. As you guys can see, I am back at the platformer tutorial project. And you guys probably know that it has been quite a while since I've made anything on this project. So you probably thought I'd cancel it, but I have not. I am back now, so yeah. And in this episode we are going to make some sound effects. And we're also going to do something else. We're going to make an idle sprite, because someone suggested that we should make an idle sprite. So I'm just going to copy SPR player and call it SPR player idle. And this is of course going to be the sprite played when he's standing still. So we can just like make it a sprite where he like blinks or something. Yeah, it doesn't really matter. Yeah, we're going to make that the idle sprite. It's going to look really stupid, but you can of course make a way better sprite yourself. So what we're going to do is simply every time up here under the sprite control under the step event, we are going to write var, and this is a temporary variable. If you write var and then a name like var has moved, then this variable will be deleted after this code has run through. So this means that it doesn't fill up memory, and therefore you can pretty much use as much as you want to. So they're pretty useful, and we're just going to set this to false up here. And when you press the left button, we're not just going to do all this code, we're also going to set health moved to true. And we're going to do the same thing under when you press the right button. Health moved equals true. And now we can down here test if health moved is equals to true, then it's going to set the sprite index to SPR player normal thing. But if it's equals to false, meaning that the player hasn't moved, it's going to set it to player idle. So this should work. Or maybe not, I don't really know, and yeah, I'm just going to put the control down there. It doesn't seem like it works for some reason. I'll just quickly take a look at that. It's a while since I've worked on this project, so oh, it's because right down here I'm setting. Yeah, I kind of forgot this. Let's just quickly take a look. Okay, it's right here the problem is. We have to move this entire thing right here, so we're just going to cut that and then remove this and then go down here and paste it and now like do this. There we go, now it should work, I hope. It does not. Okay guys, I found out what was wrong. I haven't done anything wrong actually. It's just because I forgot we of course set the image speed to 0, meaning that it doesn't animate. So this code actually worked, I think. It's just that we have to of course manually change the image index. So we just enter image index plus plus down here so that it will animate, because otherwise you of course can't see when it changes the sprite. Yeah, take a look at that, it works now. So I'm sorry about that confusion, that's just because it's been quite some time since I worked on this. So yeah. It was a very stupid mistake, but yeah, everything I did was just enter that image index plus plus down here, then it works. So yeah, now let's continue on to making the sound effects, because that was what we were supposed to do in this video. So let's go to this website called bfxr.net, and this website is pretty much a sound effect website where you can make sound effects. I think you can only make a 8-bit sound effects with this website, but you can also download SFXR, that's a program where you also can make 16-bit sound effects, but we're just going to use this one. So let's just, for example, it has all these presets. You can make your own sound over here by changing the different things here. Yeah, but you can also for example just use one of these presets and it will kind of randomize it. So yeah, So we're just going to try out, for example, making a jump sound. So let's click here, and yeah, that sounds pretty good. But if you want another sound randomized that sounds like a jump sound, you can click there again, and it makes a new one. And I like that one, but I kind of want it to be maybe a bit shorter, so we can take the sustain time down. The sustain time was what I meant to say. And now I can hear it way shorter. But if you want it to be way longer, you can take it all the way up here. But we just want it to be at zero. So now when we think this sound is fine, we can just press the export WAV file button right here, and we can save it as, let's say, character jump that WAV. So now we can go back to right here and search for character jump dot WAV, and simply just drag it in here and click the sound and then call it SOU underscore character jump. And I suggest that you use the compressed and then set this to 8-bit and then set the sample rate down to this and there, because then the sound fills a lot less, especially if it's a WAV file or WAV file or whatever it's called. Then you should do that. If it's an MP3 file, it doesn't really matter, I don't think. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go under the key press up. And as you can see right here, this is the jump code. So what we're going to write is audio play sound. And SOU underscore character jump, comma, and then the priority. And the priority is pretty much how it mixes the sounds. So if you're playing multiple sounds, and let's say you play a sound with a priority of 0, and then you play one with a priority of 1, it's going to play the one with the priority of 1, pretty much like louder than the one with the priority of 0. But if no sounds are playing on top of each other, it doesn't matter, it just sounds the same. So I'm just going to set it to 0, and then loops set that to false, because we don't want the sound to loop. So now let's just try playing and see if it works. And as you can hear, it works. And it sounds pretty nice, I think. Now we can also make a sound from when you kill an enemy, and a sound when you get hit, because we kind of need that too. So let's just try selecting hit hurt, and that sounds pretty nice, I think, when you get hit. But maybe we want it to be a bit lower frequency, like that, and maybe we want it to be more pitch jump onset, whatever that means. But I think this sounds pretty fine, so I'm just going to export this character hurt. And then I can go under this and search for character hurt.wav and drag it in here and call it SOU underscore character hurt. And again, we can compress it and put it to 8 bits and like this. So now we're just going to, I think it's under the enemy. Yes, and when it touches the player, we have to play the sound. Audio play sound, SOU underscore character hurt, and the priority should probably be 1 here, because I think the hurt sound is a bit more important than the jump sound, and again it should not loop. So now we can also make one from when you kill an enemy, and let's just use the power. Okay, that's maybe a bit, maybe mutation, maybe randomize. That's probably a bit too epic. Okay. Let's just see if we can find one that sounds nice. Okay, if I set the tech time lower. Okay, I think that sounds pretty nice. So yeah. Export WAV. Enemy hurt. So now we can again go in here just like before and search for enemy hurt, the WAV. It should appear right here, and we can drag it in here and call it SOU underscore enemy hurt. And whenever we jump on the enemy, I think the code is right Yeah, no, it's not. It must be under the stable when there's a player then. Yeah, it's right here. So with I, we also down here going to play some sound. So audio play sound. I show you underscore enemy heard priority. It is to set that to 1 and loop to 0. So now we should have some pretty nice sound effects in our game. And yeah, as you can hear, when you jump, it makes a sound effect. When you're hurt, it makes a sound effect. And when you jump on them, it makes another sound effect. And I think that this is pretty cool. I mean, it works perfectly, pretty much. So yeah, thanks for watching this video, guys, and I'll make some more of the tutorials pretty soon. So stay tuned for that, and remember to subscribe if you want to get them right in your update feed on your YouTube start page, and also like the video if you want it to be more seen because your like helps it to get higher in the YouTube search ranking. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys, and see you in the next video.